Heather Mills is in the studio at her own request because you've had enough, haven't you, really?
I've had enough. I've so had enough. I've had 18 months of absolute abuse, and then they tried to ruin my daughter's birthday party, which I spent ages organising, saying I'd killed the dog next door, which
was in yesterday's Sun, wasn't it?
Complete load of rubbish. I ended up being in contact with the lady. She'd said to get something out of the Sun that the dog had had a heart attack. I traced back to the vet, Tim, and he said, what a load of rubbish. The dog had been ill for a while and died of abdominal catastrophe on Sunday night, 24 hours after the party, because a friend of mine put some fireworks on as a surprise for my daughter, which all the village knew about and came to. And it's just like everything they write is complete rubbish.
And this was a £10,000 worth of fireworks.
Can you imagine? What
no,
a lovely friend I
have. I can't imagine what that would be like,
what
actually.
You've got to be joking.
And according to today's papers, it's only a little snippet, so don't get too worked up about this, but you spent over £100,000 on Beatrice's fourth birthday.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Everyone came. They said I banned cameras. Everyone had their cameras. I banned mobile phones. I just have friends that don't sell their pictures to newspapers. That woman that did the story on the dog, if she's so upset, what's she standing there posing for the Sun for? The day her dog's died. You know, what I just want to do, because we're short of time, is clear up a few things. For 6 years, when I lost my leg, I was the model that overcame adversity, inspired other amputees to get on with their life. Front page of all the newspapers, you know, the Sun, Model of Courage. They serialised my book. I told my whole life story in my book. It all went to charity. The Sun had it there, out on a limb. And I talked about my glamour modelling when I was a teenager. You know, pictures of me, you know, like, I wanted to be the Marie Whittaker, the Linda Lusardi, the Samantha Fox. That was the thing to be in the 80s. I was a teenager. Then they eliminate now my whole 20 years of my life of campaigning and put in things like hardcore porn queen, you know, and all this disgusting stuff from my topless things. And then the poor guy who did this book called Joy for Sex basically gets this much of apology because they call his book a hardcore porn thing. I mean, it's so ridiculous. Paul knew about my glamour modelling. It was in the papers every week for the 3 years that we were engaged. And they try and say, they broke up because she was a glamour model. It is such lies. It's never ended.
So what are you going to do?
I am going to basically, just like I changed the law with some like-minded people, anyone that wants to help, go to youcare.com, youcare.com, and you'll see how you can help and sign the petition. I need to get everybody to petition that they don't want to be lied to anymore by the press. They want their children to grow up in a society where press is just and fair, and the size of the lie that they print is the size of the apology they have to print, and they have to reveal their made-up sources and their so-called friends, unless it's a criminal situation, because they make up such lies. You know, they've called me a whore, a gold digger, a fantasist, a liar, the most unbelievably hurtful things. And I've stayed quiet for my daughter. But my daughter, we've had death threats. I've been close to suicide. So upset about this.
I know you're...
I've had worse press than a paedophile or a murderer. And I've done nothing but charity for 20 years.
Well, I actually remember you when I first started here.
I came on here talking about vegetarianism 15 years ago. I sat here and Dr. Hilary Jones said, she's crazy, she's talking about wheatgrass and giving up meat and dairy. And then they want to write that I just suddenly make up vegetarianism.
To please Paul and his family.
To please Paul. You've got footage, find it, show it. You know, it's just everyone has jumped on the bandwagon. That my sister was crying her eyes out because that awful Jordan and Peter Andre did a joke on Sunday, and I've had six amputee girls crying their eyes out because they're getting bullied at school because people are joking about the loss of my limb. Jonathan Ross.
Oh, I remember that one.
Says, she's such an effing liar. We're going to find out she's got two legs instead of one. I have protected my husband. I know everything and I know the truth. I even got an apology from, because the judge pushed for it, when they said that my petition was a lie. And the size of the apology We're sorry. We now accept that the judge did not throw out any of her claims. She was not portrayed as a liar in court and did not erupt with rage.
All right. But listen, because there will be people at home
lies.
Saying
so
at the beginning, Heather, you did use the press so that, you
I
know, if you're going to take...
I never use the press for anything except my charity. When did I promote a record? When did I act for anything? You know, they'll always say, publicity seeker, look at me going to court. My pelvis is bust. You've seen the x-ray, right?
Which you had to produce because someone else said you were lying about that.
Because they put in here, Heather's pulls her leg off and, you know...
That's when you're in Dancing with the Stars, yeah?
My pelvis has been broken for a while, but I have months where I can walk and months when I can't, right? It pops out, but I can't spend 4 months on my back in another operation while I'm going through this. This picture on this front page was taken when the paparazzi pulled the car door open.
We can't see. I know you've got a huge...
I'm showing it to you.
Yeah.
But this picture was taken when the paparazzi pulled the car door open, and then they say Heather tries to pull off a disability thing when I'm in a blacked out car hiding under a blanket because I knew I had to go into court and I knew they would turn around and say that she's trying to get publicity. It's fine that Paul can walk in going, hey, you're right, la. You know, and I'm hiding and I'm the one that is abused daily. I have protected Paul for this long and I'm trying to protect him, but I am being pushed to the edge. And I don't want my daughter, when she's 12, going on the internet, reading this totally one-sided story. I'm up to here with it. And my plan is to change the law in the European Parliament, and I will do it. And I'm fed up with the specific portion of the media. Some of them are still supportive, but a specific portion of them that are abusing me. I will investigate each and every one of those journalists.
All right, but again, this comes from the papers, so what do I know? Whether I know it's the truth or not,
but
and I know you can't talk too much about the divorce case.
But everyone jumps on the bandwagon.
But they're saying
money out of my misery.
I know, but listen, I know that, and I know you're upset, and I know you're only human, which is what people are forgetting. But during the coverage of the divorce case, they've been saying that you want 50 million, and
offered nothing. Okay. Nothing. We go to court. Nothing to do with that. We go to court over my daughter. I'm not allowed to talk about it because it's a criminal act if I talk about my daughter. You have no idea what's going on. These figures are made up: 100 million, 50 million, 20 million, this million. How do you know if I even want any money? I'm 1.5 million in debt in lawyers' fees.
Right.
And that's as much as I can say, or I go to jail for telling the truth. So I'm gagged at the moment because I'm not allowed to say a word while the media are fed this spin by a certain corner.
All right, but then again, and as I say, I only know it from the media, so what do I know? But one of the clauses apparently in this whole divorce thing is that you want to be able to sell your story. And then again,
rubbish!
Right, okay.
I could sell my story right now! I'm trying to protect Paul and our daughter. I am trying, and I'm being pushed to the edge.
Are you really where you are?
18 months of abuse, worse than a murder and paedophile. 4,400 abusive articles. Look what they're doing to the McCanns. The woman has lost, and the poor father have lost their daughter. What are we doing as a nation? What are we doing persecuting a woman that is devastated behind closed doors and trying to hold it together as I have for 18 months? What did the paparazzi do to Diana? They chased her and they killed her. Never mind all these other stories. That is what we are doing as a nation, buying this newspapers. Every time you buy one of those, you contribute to it. So force a change, that responsible journalism. You know, Rupert Murdoch, when he bought that newspaper, is quoted as saying, I can't believe how easy it was to get in the British media. I can't believe it. And I promise you, I will always give you honest and straightforward journalism. Nothing like it.
All right. Well, listen, I know you're upset and I can understand.
And they
why.
Will go for me tomorrow and they'll go, she's crazy and she's this and she's that. Go for it, because I will do even more.
All right. Well, listen, hopefully you'll stay here for a bit more as well, because we've got to go to a break now.
I'm sorry I got upset.
No,
but I'm so up to here. Can you imagine being persecuted for that long?